finding the ground, finding that place of support where your body touches the ground, that connection. Recognizing that and really sinking into that support. Finding your straight spine and your breath here. Going to do the prana mudra. And just breathe in and out a few times here. Really breathing into the chest from the back. Just being steady and recognizing that support. From here, we're going to come into Anjali Mudra or Namaste. And just checking in with ourselves here. Sensations in our head. And just asking ourselves, what's going on just now? And the question today is, what kind of pattern, what kind of wheel that we've trodden before are we holding on to as a security blanket, as something that comes from fear? What is it that rings a bell there? That familiar thing that hasn't really worked out in the past, but we're clinging to it because we are scared to move forward. Whatever it is, just observe it, don't judge it. We all have those. Just observe as an observer. And recognizing that thing. Give it a shape. What shape does it have? Is it large? Is it little? Round or square? Or all over the place? And what color does it have? recognizing the shape and color. Put it aside for now. Rubbing your hands together as you get some courage, some love, some strength. Putting that over your heart. And breathe it in. Take your fingers alongside your brows, swiping away all that stuff that needs to go. Just leaving clarity here. Moving on to our mats here, and we're just going to come into child's pose to start. Just getting some strength here from the ground. Taking some nice deep breaths and coming onto all fours. The breathing machine, cat and cow. Inhaling as we arch our back. Exhaling as we round our back. And stretching over the right side. Really stretching that side. And coming back. To the breathing machine. As we move our left foot out, stretch the left side and come forward with our arm, just really stretching it out here. And on the exhale, crossing our legs, moving on over. Excuse my cracking bones. The right hand moves to our left knee. And left arm comes back as we inhale. And exhale to the twist. Breathe. Left hand comes onto the right knee, right arm moves backward, just across from our spine. As we inhale and exhale into the twist. And coming into a yogic squat here. Coming back to that place coming into Tadasana. Recognizing the shape and color this fear has, this wheel has, and opening your hands to it. It's okay to have that wheel. We all do. And it's also okay to let it go. It is old and it cannot help us at this time. So whatever it is that you still have, that you might still be holding on to, just add it to that shape and that color that you have in your hands right now. In this offering position, we're going to step forward with the right, come back with the left, extend and offer. And letting the spirit take it up, letting earth take it, letting the past take it, and coming back with your arms to warrior three, extend your heel. Coming upward to Anjali Mudra, into Tadasana. Knowing that your left side is now free of that. Saying thanks as we come down. And just stretch the back of your legs here, however is good for you. Really extend your back, letting the rest just roll off of you here. Pushing your seat bones up and letting the base of your spine just gather all that energy that you have, your essence has, and letting it come all the way to the forefront as you feel the energy coming up your spine toward your head and coming forward to plank pose. Feeling your newfound strength here. Upward facing dog. Butt muscles are engaged. Shoulders are back and the heart leads here. And coming back into child's pose. Recognizing whatever is left in your right side of that circle, of that pattern. Coming up into Tadasana. Recognizing its shape and its color. And letting it come forward into our offering hands. And whatever else is left there in the right side of our body. To join that pattern. Stepping onto our left, moving forward, and offering up to spirit, to earth, whatever will take that back to the past. Extending our heel, letting it go. Coming back into warrior three. Tadasana. Dvajrali mudra. Recognizing the balance of both our sides present in this moment, with strength in this moment. Bowing in gratitude. Yes, we stretch through the back of your legs, of our legs, lifting up those seat bones, sit bones, as everything else, any leftovers, just roll off the back, extending forward, arms are straightening the back of the spine, again lifting as high as you can here, recognizing the energy, the newfound energy from the base of the spine all the way to the top. To plank. Recognizing your strength. And upward facing dog. Coming onto all fours. Cat and cow. The breathing machine. Taking in the new and letting go of the old. Rolling those ankles. One more time as we exhale and come into a downward facing dog. Tucking our dog, our big toes are next to each other. Lifting your back right leg here. Point and extend your heel here and coming forward into triangle pose. Tadasana. Deep breath as we engage. Our butt muscles lift up the tummy area. Rib cage is down, shoulders are down, and the heart leads. Going to step forward onto the right foot. Back leg extends. As we come forward with our right for balance, we're going to roll open left hip again, the heel extending, opening the chest. Securing yourself here. coming forward. Coming into tree pose. Tadasana. Back into plank. Upward facing dog. I'm going to use our tummy muscles now to roll over your toes. You can also optionally just twist your or bend your toes the other way. Tucking our downward facing dog, big toes are close together. So we lift the left leg back. Point and extend our heel with every breath. Come forward. Triangle pose, other side. Gently lifting up, coming forward here. Tadasana. Really grounding ourselves in the floor here, making sure our thighs are nice and engaged. Lifting the tummy. Shoulders are down. And stepping forward on our left. Coming into warrior three. Extending the right hip. Balance. Pose, recognizing the new, lifting through the hip. And let's push forward into a seat here, seated position. Going to go half lotus. And we'll practice our mudra. Recognizing the essence of ourselves here. as we open. Lifting our knees to our chest. And just relaxing here for a moment. As we roll our ankles. And coming forward into a squat. In a standing position. Lifting our right knee points downward. Our right hand comes behind with a palm facing outward, just onto our kidney here. Bend down in humility of life here, knowing that your kidneys enjoying that beautiful chi, that beautiful life energy that flows through you. And coming back up. Stepping onto the right into ego pose. As we contemplate. And coming down one more time into plank pose. And into a seated position, doing the other side. Opening lifting our knees to our chest one more time, rolling those ankles as we come into squat. Straighten those feet as we come up. Into a strong Tadasana. And lifting the left. Left hand comes over the right kidney. Palm faces backward. As we come down, giving thanks in gratitude for that beautiful chi. Moving forward, eagle pose. In contemplation. Stretching the back of the legs, the back of the back. Gathering energy in the base of your spine as we lift our seat bones here. And forward. Into plank. Upward facing dog, one more time. Taking as much time as is needed. Coming onto your back as we cross our legs over. Recognizing that beautiful support that we're being given here. And twisting, making sure your right shoulder blade stays on the floor. You can use your left arm for support. If you can't, go all the way down. Important thing is the shoulder blade, the other side stays solid here, ground. And coming back to the middle. Twisting to the other side. Making some circles here. Making some space for us on this earth, on this ground, recognizing our space. And coming into Savasana. Again, feeling the support of our head and our shoulders. wherever the body touches the ground, that support there. Finding your breath. Releasing your forehead. All those worries. Releasing your eyes from having to watch out all the time. Letting go of any tension in the nose. In the cheeks. Letting the lips go, letting the jaw go. Whatever is in your shoulders, any leftover tensions are now free to leave. Whatever you are holding in your hands, whatever you are holding on to so tight, just letting that go, giving it permission to release. Letting go of those hips and those legs. Letting the earth refill you with energy. Throw out all the old stuff and reorganize. New. Give it some time for that. Recognizing the sacred work that's happening. Staying here for as long as you need. Okay. Thank you so very much for joining me. Wishing you beautiful days and seeing you next time.